timeouts for Virginia Tech. They need to go another 84 yards to win the game. Taylor looking desperately, now throws it deep. Has a man open.
Unbelievable.
Caught! Danny Cole all the way out of bounds at the three. He did not get in.
Like we said, 58 minutes. It doesn't matter. It comes down to right now. Watch the protection first. Good job, and then Tyrod Taylor makes the play, both with his arm and with his feet. Watch right here. He's going to create a little bit, buy some time, and then spots Cole down the right sideline, and then it's just a race.
Matt O'Hanlon hustled back to make the tackle, and that could be huge with as difficult as yards have been to get for Virginia Tech. This could be a game.
Yes.
Down the field.
Virginia Tech trying to keep its national title hopes with an eye toward the national title. That strength of schedule factored in. Vic on the roll, throws toward the middle. It is caught short of a first down. And in.
Michael Vick wasting too much time right now.
They're about 25 yards away from a makeable field goal try for Graham. Vic on the roll. He's across the line of scrimmage. Up the sideline. Very close to field goal.
The game going in this direction. He was trying long distance field goal. Felt very comfortable kicking this way on the field.
Now Virginia kick we've ever asked them to make. Here's the biggest. To keep their national title hopes alive from 44 yards. It's long enough. It is right down the middle. Good for Shane Graham. There's still time in Blacksburg.
Just 1-1 this year. Right now, Virginia Tech with 2:34 left and a senior quarterback, Tyrod Taylor, about to get it back. A short kickoff to David Wilson. Wilson, better be careful. Great speed. Wilson's on his way.
Get in it here. Now, this is a guy who was nicknamed by a school teacher Wiggle Worm because he couldn't sit still in his seat. You can see why. How about that explosiveness there, Jesse, to pick up a team?
Well, he's able to find a crease up on the left side here, catches the rock, starts in the center, and really, there's not that much wiggling. He just had to run in a straight line right by the kicker on his way to the end zone. And you know what I loved? Tyrod Taylor was the first guy in the end zone to...
But keep in mind, Logan Thomas in this game, 20 of 22 in passing. He has been red hot. Recognize who they're going to block.
Yeah, oodles of time. 2:35 with four timeouts. Good protection again. Trying to build his own legend, taking over for Tyrod Taylor.
Swings it out in the flat. Wilson.
Gotten any pressure unless they brought more than that.
Wilson. First down and more. Still on his feet.
And they're not going to do that because he's in the shotgun.
Do or die, they have to get to the 18-yard line to keep this drive and the game alive.
Thomas, quarterback keeper. Holy cow, touchdown.
Attacks offensive line. Big Greg Milsel coming around 75, doing his job and opening the hole up in there.
David Wilson's the back. Taylor drifting, looking for space to run. Now he's in trouble. Stayed alive somehow and throws to the end zone. Touchdown!
Ago. Yeah. Now I get Starship 5 right here. Watch this. Marisek has him dead in the water. He reverses his field. Great sideline awareness. And you don't think these Virginia Tech Hokie receivers are good at the scramble drill, do you? That's a running back right there. How about the all-purpose skill of David Wilson, number four?
And that's all.
Let's meet our starting lineups. They need about four. He fumbles the snap. Picks it up in trouble. Rackley is coming from behind, and he dashes away from him.
How does he do that? And
the pitch. Kendrick, first down, end zone ahead. Touchdown, Hokies! Second down and eight. Vic dashing back. Here he comes again. Electrifying. First down at the 20-yard line, 15 more yards, and have you ever seen anything like this? Option for Vicky, keeps it, dashes upfield, 15, 10. First and goal. Kendrick steps to the middle, touchdown! Hokies lead it! Hokies lead it on the 6-yard run, trailing 28-7.
We're seeing it all over the country where the defensive coordinators like to make that offensive line think. They don't know where all that pressure is going to come from until the snap of the ball.
Same thing on the punt. They're coming from the quarter. They got it again! This team is incredible! It is scooped and out of bounds. It's out of bounds at the 3. No touchdown after Lee Suggs blocked the punt. Anthony Thibodeau, I believe, picked it up. Thibodeau or Wayne Ward? Let's check it out.
Suggs is going to come right through the middle, come up. And that's the thing. Look at all the starters on offense and defense that are up there trying to block punts. They put their best athletes on the team up at the line of scrimmage to get in there and fight and get through to block these punts. This time, the starting tailback, Lee Suggs, blocks that punt.
And the coach of the special teams on punt block is
Beamer ball.
Frank.
Down and 31.
31. That's a long way.
That's a long way to go. Going to be carried to the quarterback. Keep up the middle. 40. Look at the break. Down to midfield. Got the first down. Down to the 40. The 30. Big first down carry by Tyrod Taylor. Roll finally gets him.
And if you ever wonder why Frank Beamer has been drawn back into the two-quarterback controversy, you just got your answer. How do you make third and 31? You just say, Tyrod, you got the ball. Brandon Hoyer did a marvelous job of blocking. We should add that, but this is just athletic ability and presence. The ball is secured. Watch Brandon 28 accelerate. Gets a nice block.
With a stand in the final minute. Taylor designed roll to the left. Now comes back to the right. Waving receivers around. Nobody open. Running out of time. Finally throws. And it is gone! Touchdown, Dyrell Roberts!
To them, and here's the reverse. Roscoe Parrish. Parrish at the 30, and the ball is loose. Taken away in mid-air, D'Angelo Hall, and he will score.
Two. Nope, D'Angelo Hall got it. He pulled it out, picked it off, and ran it in for the touchdown.
So this capacity house is up and going a little bit crazy right now. 7-0, Virginia.
Matching at quarterback again for Kent State. Play action fake. Being chased wide open. Incomplete pass. Brandon Flowers, delivered the blow. Anaja Pruden.
You know, this hit looked a lot more painful than it really was. He just got under his shoulder pads a little bit. It didn't jar the receiver too much. But I know at home, it looks like a big time hit. And Mr. Flowers, that's his job. But I'm going to question under his shoulder pads a little bit. It didn't jar the receiver too much. But I know at home, it looks like a big time hit. And Mr. Flowers, that's his job.
Blacksburg, Virginia. Folks, we go to noisy stadiums all around the country. I'm not sure we have ever been in a scene where fans are any more pumped than they are right here tonight. Waiting right now for the Hokies to take the field. They are jumping, they are screaming, and it's been this way for the last 30 minutes. Frank Beamer waits in the tunnel. This is the date that they have pinpointed on the can. Haven't been for a very, very long time.
And then to have the balance to get into the end zone. He starts to run out of gas here a little bit. Johnson catches up to him. He's trying to just bring him down, push him out of bounds. The stiff arm and into the end zone. And how important is Virginia Tech and the way their defense has played to force the field goals and how quickly a game that's been pretty well.
On second down and nine. Taylor wants to take off, wants daylight. And did he keep the knee up and pick up a first down? That would be a remarkable piece of footwork by Tyrod Taylor, the Hokies' leading rusher. That's a little bit of Houdini right there.
The football to help keep you up, and I don't know if he did. The ball gets down close. His knee never touches. His hand touches, not the football, but his hand touches. A good no call to keep that play alive.
11 yards on that run, and they're going to run this back, and they're going to see if this is legal.
Brent, I cannot wait to see this call because the back of his hand touches the ground. Now, obviously, if the front of your hand touches the ground, like his left hand is doing, you can do that all day.
It's 2 out of 4, did have a big drop. 56 seconds for Thomas to use that big arm. He fires a dart to Danny Cole. Cole still on his feet. Danny Cole on his way. Touchdown, Virginia Tech.
Football up 4 points with 1 minute to go in the half. It's a waggle to the right. It looked as if Logan might want to throw it back to the other sideline, but Danny Cole, the best route runner of this receiving group, doing a nice job working his way in here on this last touchdown. Two safeties going to split in the middle of the field, and Danny Cole is just going to do a nice job working his way into the middle of the field for this touchdown. The arm strength on Logan Thomas is off the charts. 90% of the starting quarterbacks in the National Football League can't complete that pass with the zip that Logan Thomas just executed.
But for me, what happened here is Al Groh's defense.
Stick it in, stick it in, stick it in.
Be a big plus for that ball.
Well, they're going to try to run one play, and it better be a quick one as Groh throws. Yeah, intercepted. Picked off by Virginia Tech. Antonio Banks takes it all the way. Virginia Tech wins 9 in a row to close out a phenomenal season, and they do it in amazing fashion. They come back with 16 points in the final quarter to win going away on the final play of the game.
Well, Mike Rose doing what he's supposed to do here, trying to throw the ball outside to stop the clock and get a chance for the field goal. And Banks steps up. He knows it's going to be a short pass, picks it off, takes it the distance. Nice play, good coaching by Virginia Tech secondary coach, getting him up there ready for the short play on the outside.
Tiki Barber tried to come in and make the tackle, but Banks shrugged him off and went 65 yards with the interception return to make the final score.
From the 20, Brian Randall starts the drive. Got time. Oh, receiver wide open. It's Royal. Eddie Royal trying to pick up blocks downfield and uses speed. Eddie Royal going to go. Virginia Tech within two. 80-yard touchdown. They'll go for two to try to tie. A huge bust in coverage. Royal's second career touchdown.
I think Brian Randall was the most excited guy in the stadium the way he threw that football. Broken coverage. The thing that's the most impressive is what Royal does. He doesn't just try to outrun Landry in the corner. He gets back, allows his tight end, and look at the speed and that burst to run away from James Butler.
I'm not so sure it was busted coverage as much as I think it was cover two, and the safety didn't come.
It's a third down and two at the 37. Vic on the option. Uh-oh, he's got room. He breaks the tackle. Can anybody get him? He's cutting back against the grain. I think it's lights out. Michael Vick again takes it to the house. 63 yards for the touchdown.
Michael Vick has done since he came to Virginia Tech. You cannot miss a tackle. Right there. Missed tackle. Results in a touchdown when you've got a quarterback that runs a 4.25 40. And the one thing about it, Frank Beamer said yesterday, you know what, our number two quarterback's pretty good, he says, but there aren't any number ones like ours.
Possibly be saying after that.
I think Ricky's probably telling him, you know, Michael, this is exactly how I thought it. Number three, Mike Young, the safety, misses a tackle. You can't do that. Michael Vick, to me, the most exciting college football player to come on the scene in the last 20 years.
Interception. Each quarterback threw an interception, led to a score for another team. Taylor looks like he is going to heave one deep, and why not? He has a man behind the defense. Caught! But Jared Boykin is down short of the end zone, and time has run out. The replay communicator and Paul Schmidt, the replay official.
There's the ball. They said they called the timeout.
Well, when is he down?
Knee is down 2 seconds.
2 seconds. And he made it. So we could look back on the final seconds of this first half as the key to the game.
And it's Evans again. Running left. First down. Involved tonight. This is Evans. Evans breaks free. Darren Evans barreling inside the 30. Usually they don't mind that because the opponents have more trouble than they do, but it's nice to have beautiful weather. And bouncing it is Darren Evans. Evans to midfield. Run out at the 30. Hookie's now backed up, and they'll just hand it to Evans on first down. And they'll stiff arm Darren Evans into the secondary and tight roping down the sidelines.
Workhorse again.
Oh! Terrell
just got flattened.
I don't know. They're going to have to win an ugly defensive game, I think. Evans just added to his total, Darren Evans, and inside the 20. This has become...
Smith in motion. They go with a running play. Evans turns the corner, has the first down, plus about five more yards. He'll take it to the 40. Taylor, great protection. Now it breaks down. Gonna run it. Ran it to his own man and got free. And he's gonna wide to put a gain of 5 yards. Quarterback draw. Tyrod Taylor gonna have the first down inside the NC State 40-yard line. Over the middle, got his man, breaks the tackle. That's Boykin. Boykin still on his feet, and he will score. 39 yards. For starters, it was an absolute...
Drive kick. That's what... From the 18, trying to get to the wall.
Well, again, you're so concerned about protecting your punter. Protect your punter. Now you got to cover the kick. You got to stay in your lanes. You got to break down and make a play. Watch this. One guy you got to make miss. Right there it is. You make the first guy miss, which Eddie Royal does. Then he's going to pick up blocks on the way to the end zone. And the last block is going to be Justin Harper, who blocks the punter Maynard. He just ties him up, keeps him away from the return man. And Eddie Royal with a big-time return. He was an all-conference returner a year ago. He makes another big play for the Hokies tonight.
And happy birthday, Mom. Mm. Virginia Tech with 104.
One interception return for a touchdown. One kick return for a touchdown.
Virginia Tech will run it out from the end zone. Macho Harris, 25 blockers in front. Look out. Buchholz trying to slow him up, but he's taken down, and Macho Harris.
Now let's add one more explosive play.
100 yards. Virginia Tech's calling card, and it's killing Clemson.
And this is poor coverage, because watch right here. Victor, he has no blockers. He's returning right here, and there's nothing. And he's just going to reverse his field on his own and then pick up blockers. I mean, that's poor coverage by Clemson, not disciplined in their lanes, not getting down there fast enough. And Macho Harris just made a play. I mean, he was returning it right, saw a lane to the left, and took it himself.
And it's 100 yards, not 102, because that's all they'll give you in college, no. Is 100.
Woodcock in motion. Nunes lobs it long. It's way too far overthrown, and Woodcock took a pretty good shot, and he is going to get up. No, he's not. He's going to go back down. Ike Charlton is the man who hit him.
That's the other thing. You're going to find the receivers going back to the huddle saying, hey, don't hang me out there. And they've had a couple of these
where
the quarterbacks are hanging the receivers out, and they're getting walloped. That's Pat Woodcock, who played his high school football in Canada and came down to Michigan or Syracuse and where he was going to go to college. Nunes trying under pressure, hangs the ball up, and Ike Charlton just finishes off Pat Woodcock.
Boy, he's exposed in an upper high, the high rib cage just underneath that right shoulder blade is where he got the shoulder pads.
If you're wearing a white jersey here, you're going to get hit.
With the pressure on Tyrod Taylor.
So Taylor is out, at least for now. Logan Thomas, a redshirt freshman who has thrown 24 passes this season, comes in on a third and 16. Got quite a bit of time against Wake Forest in a blowout earlier this season.
Even caught a touchdown pass in that game, but really has not seen any extended action at the quarterback position.
Taylor a little woozy over on the sidelines. He's in there. on a third and 16. He has time over the middle, has a man open, and he finds Danny Cole, and then Cole takes a hit and loses his helmet, but holds onto the football.
How about Logan Thomas off the bench with hardly any warm-up time? I mean, it wasn't like Tyrod was down. He was getting to throw on the sideline, steps right into the... Delivers a bullet down the middle of the field. Really impressed with that throw. Great protection here, something Tyrod hadn't got to this point. But Danny Cole just splitting the middle of that defense. Von Telemach coming up later with a big hit.
Led by ACC Player of the Year Tyrod Taylor, Virginia Tech has won 10 in a row. He sends Jared Boykin to the right. On third down out of the I formation, Boykin comes in motion. A play fake for Taylor. Blitzes on. Tyrod scrambles left. Lets it go to the end zone. It is caught by Boykin. Touchdown Tech. A spinning throw. A shotgun snap to the Virginia Tech senior. Number 5 in white. Fires it deep. Danny Cole wide open and over the shoulder grab on the 20. Left sideline to the 10. And he will score. Side of the field is to the left. Knowles come on the blitz. Tyrod in trouble. Heaves it. Right side. Wilson open at the 5. Into the end zone. Touchdown Tech. It is Tyrod Taylor's night, folks. Three receivers to the right. One to the left. Danny Cole started in motion, goes back to the right. Shotgun snap, Tyrod rolling right, stops. Now he's going to run back to the left, try to get to the corner. Cuts inside and waltzes in casually. Touchdown Tech. The magical night continues for Taylor. They beat the Florida State Seminoles in the ACC Championship game thanks to Taylor's heroics.
Here comes a blitz.
He was going to make something happen. Sturdivant comes from the outside linebacker position, and he gets to him. How about Bud? Bud's ready to put on a chin strap and go get somebody. That man can coach football, ladies and gentlemen. Position, and he gets to him. How about Bud? Bud's ready to put on a chin strap and go get somebody. That man can coach football, ladies and gentlemen.
And they know what this means. No bowl for Virginia. Glennon takes a knee. And, of course, Frank Beard.
Initially by Glaspie.
Playoff, and they're out of timeouts. Takes a snap in the shotgun just in time. Ryan has it batted in the air, and it's intercepted. Flags are down. Virginia Tech, the DB's got it, and he's heading to the end zone. Touchdown, Virginia Tech. Ball was batted in the air by Barry Booker.
There's a DB, number 11. Booker does a nice job. Booker knocks it up into the air. A DB's had a great game. Most of the time, he's been covering Callender out of the backfield. Stuffing the run, Adibi the linebacker, is going to be an outstanding. He's a fifth-year senior playing his last regular season game.
How about the two senior linebackers making interceptions late in the game ice the win for Virginia Tech?
Yep. Good class.
The Virginia Tech Hokies are the Atlantic Coast Conference champions for 2007.
Jones back in the ball game, and look out. Breaks two tackles, still on his feet at the 37-yard line. 22 yards for Kevin Jones.
And boy, Kevin Jones, you've got to figure with him and Lee Suggs there. They get along fine. There is no bitterness in their rivalry. But trust me, it is a rivalry, Tim. We've all been there with good friends.
Virginia Tech. Here's Jones. Got Eastlick in front of him. Tigers aren't rapid. Missing tackles. Here comes Jones, still on his feet. He's got blockers. To the 20. 10. Inside the 5 for Kevin Jones. 33 yards after being wrapped up and missed. A yard deep in the backfield. He had trying to get a block.
Boy, as an old Redskins fan, this brings back horrible memories of Marcus Allen in the Super Bowl. But Marcus Allen.
Now Miami wants to talk about it. Several of these pass plays in this last possession. The first one took 11 seconds off the clock. 11 seconds, it resulted in incompletion. They have not managed the clock very well, but you can say that to Jacory Harris, but if he can't find anybody open, he can't find anybody open.
Let me tell you what has become open, this crowd. That makes the task of Al Golden and Jacory Harris that much more difficult. You lose a little bit of your composure and your focus and understanding of the down and the distance in the game. At this point now, they cannot let the ball die inbounds.
Look at this. This is just spectacular. These people are losing their mind. This is beautiful.
And I would have held a lot better than he did.
First and goal from the two. Ryan Williams, touchdown Virginia Tech. To go first quarter. Taylor has a man open down the middle. Caught! Jared Boykin, touchdown Hokie. A better decision by the quarterback. He thought they were very close to being a crisp offense. They've been that today. Josh Oglesby refusing to go down. Now Bosher has it blocked. Cam Chancellor blocked it. And it's taken into the end zone. Here's Ryan Williams on first down. Breaks free. Boy, the tackling awful for my. And Virginia Tech victorious today, 31-7.
Orange Bowl. For Cincinnati, their inaugural trip to a BCS game as champions of the Big East Conference. And for Virginia Tech, champions of the ACC, they're in a BCS game for the fourth time.
Session, so our kids will be ready to play.
All right, good luck. Happy New Year, Coach.
Thanks, Chris.
All right, Tommy, one man can.
Cole. Taylor steps out of the pocket and tiptoes his way inside the 10, inside the 5, touchdown! MVP.
And it doesn't matter what the scouting report is, everyone knows this is where Tyrod Taylor is his most dangerous, but he makes people miss. Ryan Manilak misses, Corey Smith misses. And Taylor dances into the end zone. Sometimes just great athletic plays beat all defenses. Even posed to go.
Pike rolls, lost it down the sideline for Goodman. Jump ball, and was it intercepted? It is an interception, batted away by Pike. Escapes trouble. Intercepted in the end zone by Virgil. Second down and 10. That's play action. And Pike down the middle of the field. And it is intercepted again. It's Cam Chancellor. Pike being chased. And was it picked off? It is an interception by Orion Martin. Pike on first down with under 2.5 to play. Throws his fourth interception of the night, and this one's Cody Grimm. And the celebration is on in Blacksburg, Virginia. Pike on the keeper. And is denied the end zone.
Tonight. There he is. Look at him. Ooh, that feels so good.
Yes, it does. When you BCS National Championship game, but again, Chris and company standing by in LA after this.
schemer. Here's Thomas. Inside like a fullback.
Ditto. As long as it's a sneak.
It is. Logan Thomas.
Down. This is a no-brainer here. Georgia Tech, the last several quarterback sneaks, has given up 4 and 5 yards to look. That his shoulder is okay. He had a little banged up shoulder and they tried to protect him. He takes on Sean Spence. Great line.
In the backfields, Thomas will keep left side. Big man breaks one.
Outside and the running back inside.
Quarterback sneak. Right on cue. Thomas still carrying people.
Helmets on Georgia Tech getting down low enough. You can't tackle the football against two.
By Thomas, the quarterback. Now, this is no ordinary quarterback. Watch this hit. He's a tight end. Oh! That's a decleater.
Fry from the left hash mark. Vic the snap. Option keeper. Michael running into the end zone. He's in. Touchdown, Tech. Vic scores his first collegiate touchdown, and Tech leads 6-0. By Michael Vick. Here's Vic taking the snap, scrambling, running with the football. Crosses the 50, turning on the Jets. Look at that speed! He's racing all the way into the end zone. Touchdown, Tech! They couldn't catch him. Michael Vick sprints for his second touchdown. A 54-yard run. Third down on the 6. There's the shotgun snap to the Tech freshman. Running with the football, has a seam at the 5, goes airborne into the end zone. Touchdown, Tech! A sensational flip by Vic.
And 3 inches. It is good. Well, the game is over. But wait a minute, there's a flag down. It is a roughing the kicker. Obviously, it means nothing.
The first coach in the history of Virginia Tech ever to win a bowl game in his last game at Virginia Tech. It'd make a great movie, wouldn't it?
Among other places, they can celebrate in Blacksburg, Virginia, and in Dublin, Virginia, in Pulaski County. That's the home of Chris Kinzer.
You know, a game like this...
Didn't you say before the game it could come down to the summarizing to do, as we'll tell you the final score, Virginia Tech... 25. North Carolina State, 24.
And they just make play after play.
They are number one and number two in tackles. And that's going to be an incomplete pass because Victor Macho Harris saw the pass coming and went flying up from the corner.
When you play Clemson, you need to work on the run and you need to deal with their screens. They're a big screen team. That time, Clemson just laying there waiting for it, and Victor Harris ready to make the hit. And Kelly, and they're without their fastest receiver, Jacoby Ford. There he is again.
Well, I tell you what, when you throw the ball out,
worst of this collision, but they know this is Clemson's offense. They run tons of screens, the bubble screens, and if you get past that first block and if you're aggressive enough, you can do this every time, get hits in the backfield. We saw one play that worked.
Clock will start again. As you see, 58 seconds remaining. Now the ball at the 32 of Virginia. First down. Rucky Miller wants to go long. He has Holmes. Touchdown!
Well, look at here, Druckenmiller. He's going to look and he's going to pump right there. You can stop. You see Ellsworth step forward. That's what happened. He sucked up on the fake and Holmes went right by him. Take a look here, Druckenmiller. See the fake there. Throws the ball out over the top. Ellsworth, who has the deep half on that side of the field, sucked up on the fake and it's a touchdown by the Hokies.
Virginia Tech goes 71 yards in 10 plays. And you can't blame Jermaine Holmes for jumping for joy as they score.
This Virginia Tech defense just was on the field for a very long drive. It's been one play. Now they have to go back out again. These guys have to get ready, catch their wind, get some water.
How about this scene? Does it get any better than Thursday night in Blacksburg? .223 left. Virginia Tech's going to make sure that B.J. Bossett doesn't have the opportunity that Wilson had. Saturday night football continues. Nick Foles expected to return for Arizona against...
Ball game at left tackle replacing Brandon Fry. Kenny Lewis back in the game at tailback. The ball is tipped. Eddie Royal can throw it because it was a backward pass. Wide open, the tight end at the 5, and touchdown, Sam Wheeler. 53 yards, and here is the difficult thing for Georgia. When the ball got tipped, they all stopped, but it was obviously a backward pass. Eddie Royal never broke motion or set up the whole way. They're going to have the tight end running right down the middle, Ron. This was going to be a throw right from the start. And just because it got tipped, you're exactly right. The entire Georgia defense stopped. The safety had already come up and bit on the ball. And Sam Wheeler, a freshman tight end, running wide open down the middle.
And Tim. Shinsky to throw, has a man there. Picked off in the end zone. Hosley, Jaron Hosley.
Third down. Wilson throws it far sideline into coverage, and I think this one got picked off. It did by Hosley. 13th play of the drive. Wilson throws it for the end zone and throws it too low, intercepted by Hosley. To get him out as a safety valve. Now looking deep over the middle. Battling for it. It's intercepted by Virginia Tech. Back to the 40, the 30, to the 20-yard line, and down the sideline. Hosley.
On it. Sprints out. Draeger had him. He'll throw it. It's intercepted by Hosley. Hosley takes it all the way to the end zone.
Adams in motion. They fake the sweep to him. And Yates is going to go deep. Double covered. And intercepted.
Try to get the rest of it.
We need to get to the 24 of the Hokies for a first down. He's going to go deep looking for Adams. And double cover intercepted. Hosley's going to take it out.
Virginia Tech, 16 in the BCS standings. Miami at 24. And that's a pick. Jaron Hosley, who leads the nation in interceptions.
Line of great quarterbacks on the farm in Palo Alto, Luck the latest. Second and 9. His throw is intercepted. Jaron Hosley leads the nation in INTs. Has a knife.
15th ranked Syracuse versus number 4 Virginia Tech tonight from Blacksburg. Watch from the sideline. You see those linebackers come up tight, quick pass, and he got it away. The ball is fumbled and picked off in the air. Virginia Tech has had it all their way. Did anybody stay at home? Yes, Dick for the end zone. Hill to climb in this one. 14th play of the drive. Stiff over the top. Touchdown, Virginia Tech. Go with him in this ball.
I think this is it.
They're going to run a little reverse right here. Andre Davis gets a nice block. And he'll... Intercepted. Summers. And he'll score. Dropped another one. Going to be tackled. This is recovered in 300th win against his son Tommy and his Clemson Tigers.
College football on ABC. Two of the top 15. Georgia Tech ranked 15. Virginia Tech, they are fourth. Both are 3-0. Both in the ACC. At the 25. Fourth down and 8. Goes for the field goal. And it's blocked. And this is where Virginia Tech excels. Down to the 40, to the 50-yard line, nobody in front. Dennis Davis, touchdown!
Found which guy was hot and played him. Now they've just got so much depth.
Looking for Royal. Look at the time. Royal's open at the 40-yard line. 35, down to the 20. 15 for ball. See if he tries to go deep. He's got Johnson near side. Goes up the middle. That's going to be intercepted towards the end zone. And touchdown! Anything up. They'll put four down and rush the linebackers in the corners. Over the middle, another interception. End zone ahead. Reggie Baldy only there. Touchdown. It's going to be coming up for incoming M. Dave Lamont and all of our crew. I'm Gary Thorne. Thank you.
See, they call a ball play here. Here's the blitz. Vic dodges out. Look at him run. Oh, my gosh. Foot race. He's got one man to beat, and he's got a shield downfield. Michael Vic. Amazing. A flag is down. Face mask. Extraordinary.
The blitz, it's there. Boston College has him. They can't wrap him up. And then it's turn out the lights. 4.25 speed, faster than anybody on the field. Forget about it.
Of another look.
Blacksburg, number two Virginia Tech, trailed at halftime, first time they've trailed all season, now leading by six. They've scored on their first two possessions here in the third quarter. And after West Virginia went for it on fourth down, it's good field position for Michael Vick and the Hokies. Michael's loading up and looking long. Away from making that play all year.
There's Wilson. Wilson looking for a seam. Still on his feet, but I'm not sure that's a good thing right now. Continuing to lose ground, and he's got a wave of blockers out there. Wilson out to the 35. What a run! Courtney Brown almost had him down, but he got out of his grasp. Frank Beamer can't get any more gray hair. He's all the way white, so I'm not sure. But let's give a little bit of credit to Darius Robinson, the cornerback, right here at the very end. Even though he gets cut down, does a great job.
All right, yep. Sets up a third down and one. Higgins sacked back at the 40-yard line. That's going to be a flag on the play as well. There's going to be a hold. DeBrickashaw Ferguson got beaten by Darrell Tapp. And we talked about Tapp in the first half. The trend continues here in the third quarter. Tough to slow. How do you slow him down, Chris?
Well, you got a pretty good player and a future pro in DeBrickashaw Ferguson going against the pass rusher, and your guys, your good's got to be better than their good, and that time Tapp's good was better than DeBrickashaw's good. But here's the two guys you're going to look at. Watch Tapp come off the ball. Let's see what kind of move he has. There's a nice push swim, and DeBrickashaw, not an intentional face mask, his hand just gets up, but watch, he sets him up inside, and he comes with a rip, and that's just effort and tenacity and a...
Mark, this is a great one. At about 2:30 a.m. this morning, University of Virginia officials estimate that somebody broke into the Scott Stadium here and painted a big old T next to the V at midfield.
straight for Virginia Tech. They have won. You know, no matter what, Frank Beamer's Virginia Tech squad is always going to be ready for a challenge. The Hokies will definitely have the house tonight, and right now, they have the floor.
Front. Second down and six from the 19, Virginia Tech rolling. First possession of the second half. Taylor hands it off to Williams.
He doesn't care if he has a jersey or not. He's going to run with it. And this is what I like about it. Right here again, you see the hole open up. And look at this. Talk about a workhorse back. I don't care if you're holding me back. I'm still going to run through it. Look at this.
Look how far he drags her.
Oh, my goodness.
And they give him the touchdown. Looked at it one more time.
Guys that are my height, that are like me or play like me, kind of get moved at my position. The numbers that I put up will draw your eyes to some positions, running back, wide receiver, but I don't think you should use that against me. I'm a quarterback, always been a quarterback, only played quarterback.
Ass through the area.
I was on 3 step, quick
three
young.
Step.
Y'all look good.
He will be here 5 days a week, 6 to 8 weeks minimum.
See, you want, soon when he coming out of that break, your arm should be caught.
Which is your three-step drop and your five-step and your seven-step and your rollout and your boots and all your throws.
Tyrod's extended family, his agent staff, and his parents have all gathered at a hotel to wait together to hear Ty's name called.
Come on, come on. Come on, Philly. Ty might fall right to the Jets, man.
I think it should happen here, man.
Yeah,
let's go for a walk, man. Leave me outside.
Tyrod and his parents decide to take a break from the television. They aren't watching when the sixth round begins.
With the 180th selection, the 2011 NFL Draft, the Baltimore Ravens have selected Tyrod Taylor, quarterback, Virginia Tech.
Baltimore, Tyrod Taylor, Baltimore Ravens.
Listen, I am a quarterback, and I want to play quarterback
for the next
couple of
weeks. Oh, my God. Proud of you,
boy. Appreciate it, man.
Appreciate it. Been a long road.
Yeah.
Let's play ball.
This is the last meeting in the foreseeable future. Certainly that'll add a serrated edge to the sword that cuts through this fierce rivalry. But for the Hokies all season, on third and nine, Marcus Bick, quarterback draw. No problems on third down, touchdown. Plenty of time, has his tight end, Jeff King, for another. Hokies led 10 to nothing, but the Mountaineers scored on their last drive. Bick wide open. Vick is just taking apart that secondary.
Well,
Marcus Vick is 8 touchdown pass of the season. King and Vick sounds like a law firm. They're bringing law and order to the gridiron right now. Down and 10 out of the shotgun as Marcus Vick has some room. Vic has the first down and then some at the 15-yard line.
But see, look.
Rile him up too much.
Out of the shotgun. Into the end zone. That's what happens when you make them mad. Touchdown, Royal. They won't meet at least until 2015.
Five as he gets the snap away to Orr. Tries to turn the corner. Does get around the corner. Forced out of bounds, but he is.
We don't have that tandem for Virginia Tech, so it's all number 28.
Orr up the middle. Orr in a foot race to the corner. Dives to the pylon, ruled out of. Carlton Weatherford is the big fullback leading Orr, who breaks a tackle and gets a first down and more before Dwayne Coleman can drag him down at the
284 yards. I think it gave him confidence coming into tonight.
Orr breaks tackles again, fights for the end zone, touchdown. No adversity right now for the Hokies, and they'll go back to Orr. Orr keeps his feet. Orr fighting for the corner, shoved out inside the five. Orr leaves across the goal line for a touchdown. The effort Frank Beamer was looking for. Right back in the ACC race.
Well, we said strange things happen on Thursday night. We got a post-Halloween mystery that has yet to be unraveled. And for more on that, we get down to the field and Atlanta's own Aaron Andrews, CA.
Well, Virginia Tech dealing with a trick more than a treat, like you said, a day after Halloween. Well, Hokies equipment manager Lester Carlin walked into the team's locker room today at about 3 p.m. Four starters' jerseys were missing. Sean Glennon, Tyrod Taylor, Cam Chancellor, Brandon Flowers. He set the jerseys out last night around 7. Today, they were gone. Now, Georgia Tech is claiming in order to get to the Hokies locker room, you have to go through three doors. One had a lock on it, one had a surveillance camera, and the other one had a guard there. There is no evidence that anyone walked out with those jerseys. There's nothing on the surveillance camera either, Chris. So the priority at hand, getting the players in jerseys. What they're wearing is Georgia Tech's old jerseys from 3 years ago, and it's pretty creative what they did. They scribbled out the yellow jackets with magic marker. Nike's even having them put a fake swoosh on there with magic marker. So we're going to have to be reminding people of this all night long. You're not seeing yellow jackets out there. Those are Hokies.
It was all about playing under the lights. Here's an onside kick. And covered at the 42-yard line, Virginia Tech football. First down throw from Glennon. Fires near sideline. Royal has it. Sips back inside. Eddie Royal. Cracked down at the win. Good field position in plus territory, and it's Kenny Lewis Jr. They fake it to him. Wide open over the middle is Justin Harper. One play.
They couldn't find Sean Glennon's jersey in Blacksburg, so it's missing there, too.
Glennon fires downfield, looks for Morgan. Jump ball caught by Josh Morgan, who just stroll into the end zone. Winning loss for Georgia Tech.
But this time, Virginia Tech did something different. They put Corey Moore on the opposite side. They thought he was going to be on the other side, and he comes. Are you sure there's not 256?
How about that attempted block by Zachary?
Forget about it.
And Corey's learned a lot from the former great Virginia Tech star Cordell Brown.
He forced the turnover. He scoops. He scores.
Best in the match.
Forces the fumble, recovers it, and does color, too.
Yes.
Corey Moore, he just said best in the nation. I don't know if he's talking about his team or him, because he is one of the best, if not the best, defensive lineman in college football. Here he makes so many plays in the first half. He comes back after they try to go away from him. And now, look at it. What is this, little pineapple?
Virginia Tech in Miami, their first year in the ACC, and now they will meet for the title. Play fake, they're gonna throw for it. Berlin goes deep, intercepted. That was a big gamble for Miami, fourth and
second and long, and the Hokies.
Roll can't get there. He's picked up. Complete. A first down to the 38 game in the ACC Conference. Miami with the football on a play fake by Brock Berlin. Rolls right. Receivers covered. Fumble! And Bartek gets it back. Two tight ends and two wides off to the right. And Hume slashes to daylight. First down. Replaces him. Randall steps away from the pressure. Breaks free of a tackle into the secondary. And down at the play fake to Humes. Randall with plenty of time. Fires. Royals got it. 10-5. Touchdown. Hokies lead.
Well, Coach, congratulations. ACC champions.
Wow.
And there's a look at head coach Frank Beamer. And here come the Hokies. Out of the hills of Southwest Virginia, the co-champions of the Big East Conference.
All five of those guys are big playmakers for Texas. If you take a look at Bud Foster, one of the co-defensive coordinators for Virginia Tech.
Eye out for number 83. Where is he? He doesn't emerge on this one. Schultes hangs it up high. Green at the 41-yard line. And here comes Brian Still. Brian Still is going to take this one to the house. Touchdown, Hokies. 13 out of the shotgun. Druckenmiller complete. Still at the two.
Versatile defender.
And he's coming on the blitz on this play, but Brown gets it away and he's picked off. It's intercepted by William Yarbrough. Texas coming on a blitz. Druckenmiller has Still wide open. Touchdown, Hokies. Davis in the slot. And he looks for Davis, and he's picked off by big play Torian Gray. And Gray sits down at the 33.
And try to get it into overtime.
Out of the shotgun, third and 10, pressure. Brown gets it off, and he's picked off by Torian Gray.
The Texas offense. Texas had 226 total yards, their lowest output of the season.
And that's the play that Frank Beamer didn't call today. For Dean Blevins and Todd Blackledge, I'm Mark Jones. The final score, 28-10, folks.
Soon the Hokies will take this field.
45 seconds to air, ladies and gentlemen. 45.
In 10, 9, 8.
Ready, A.
7, 6, in 5, 4, 3, 2, roll.
Wayne Stadium in Blacksburg, Virginia. Folks, we go to noisy stadiums all around the country. I'm not sure we have ever been in a scene where fans are any more pumped than they are right here tonight.
And there's not much better than watching 66,000 strong welcome their Hokies.